As a young man living on the soil of Trinidad, raised in a middle-income family and having the dream to become an accredited accountant, little did he know that his journey would kick off on a road not too distant from his dream to be a celebrated professional in the world of finance.
42 years ago, you began serving Republic Bank. And the result of your sacrifices has led to building this great institution. You spent just 7% of your working life in Ghana. But I believe that you have made great impact in the lives of staff, people, and communities.
After 39 years of professional and practical exposures in banking, many years of leading strategies and business transformation, many years of leadership, coaching, and facilitating teams, decades of believing and living the values of Republic Bank.
Hello, you're welcome.
Now, I am here as a leader to continue and build the next level of banking experience. My name is Farid Antar. I am the new Managing Director of Republic Bank Ghana. Expect something bigger.
Was born one of seven children in Barataria, a small suburb east of Port of Spain, the capital city of Trinidad and Tobago, to a father who was an immigrant from Lebanon and a mother, fifth generation Trinidadian of French descent some 50 odd years ago. Mr. Antar started his career journey in Republic Bank, then Barclays Bank DCO in 1979. During his over 43 years of service at Republic Bank, he has held several roles within the Republic Bank Group. With a career spanning over 43 years of service to Republic Bank, laced with hard work, fortitude and excellence, Mr. Antar, a man of character, discipline and humility, has earned the right to proudly beat his chest for the many successes he has won for himself and for the bank as a whole in a relatively short period of time.
Farid, the bank you're running today is a very different place from the bank you came to meet. You must remember, and I certainly do, that at the time I joined the board, we were coming out of a period of turbulence, a period of change. There was no certainty as to the direction of the bank. A lot of work was done by your predecessors to address some of these problems, but you came to meet what was still a difficult situation.
When you came, Home Finance had become HFC Limited, and HFC had also moved into Republic Bank, Ghana. So you came at more or less a transitional period. So the bank, as it were, something had been done. It now becomes your responsibility to exploit and add to the gain.
And your coming on board has been of immense benefit to Republic Bank, the board, the executive, and staff.
In the course of your tenure, the bank has witnessed positive changes in its fortunes.
Within his time as the managing director of Republic Bank Ghana, the bank has seen significant improvements in many areas, as well as won many local and recently two international awards.
Indeed, his time in Ghana has been too long and too short a time. Long because if you look at what he's done over the last 3 years, it is such remarkable that any party who is not part of the Republic Bank Group it will be difficult for such a person to comprehend that all this were achieved within a space of 3 years.
For instance, there's been an improvement in the bank's bottom line. So has the bank's brand image been rising. The rise in the image is largely due to the strategic sighting of the Republic Court, as well as the activities in respect of our corporate social responsibility.
For the first time, we are paying dividends to our shareholders. All the economics seem to be pointing up north. We have seen our profit after tax jumping from about 58% from 2020 to 2021. Now it stands at 89.9 odd million. Our assets grown from 3.34 billion to 4.2 billion.
With his presence and leadership, the bank has been able to undertake a massive digital transformation. And with that, we have been able to successfully launch a new mobile internet banking and then USSD that is currently performing well.
The introduction of two new mortgage repayment options, first bank to launch business credit cards in Ghana, first digital Susu product, and recently the bank's first international awards. Not just one, but two. That was the height for me. And not forgetting the exposure you gave Republic Bank Ghana in many international markets.
Today, Republic Bank Ghana is a leader in the credit card business in Ghana.
Throughout the project stage, I mean, his contributions, his leadership refined us. The product we see today and celebrate today is all through his leadership. Not only did he lead and direct, but he was involved in testing the product. He once told me, "Jessica, if there's anything wrong with this product, trust me to find it." And truly, he did find a few things that we were able to refine.
Mr. Anta is not only a game changer, but also a critical thinker and an influencer in all areas.
When Republic Investments sought to introduce a new product, the Republic World Trust, a fixed income collective investment scheme to the market, we equally needed to go through group for a no objection, to secure our board approvals, to get our regulatory approvals, and also to get interest from investors to participate in the IPO. Farid was with us throughout these processes. Not once was he missing. We secured all the approvals there was. At the end of the IPO, we raised 7 times the minimum that was required by the regulator. We also raised more than 2 times the target that we set for ourselves internally, however aggressive that was.
It was last year when we were wrapping up on our campaign materials for production. You called me personally and we spoke for close to an hour on the phone. You took your time to take me through all the key changes you required. This to me was remarkable.
When an audit report is sent to him, it will take time, analyze sentence by sentence, and then send the report back to the clients, praising them for the areas that they have done well, and then cautioning them for the areas that we have to look at.
When I took on the role as a treasurer, one of the beautiful things I felt were days that we had to engage in an analysis for loan repricing and investment repricing. I wondered whether Mr. Farid Anta had a PhD in mathematics because of his ability to critique figures. And trust me, before you send those documents, you have to check. Check and check again. Because that dot that everybody will miss, Mr. Farid Anta will see it.
He has, over the period, moved everyone, and when I say everyone, everyone in the group, to actually get to the very expected level that the group is actually looking for.
Farid has a special touch with staff. He took staff welfare as his utmost concern and lived the values of the bank.
And over the period that he was here, he ensured that he pushed for key staff initiatives One of them was the revamping of the staff loans, the MAP and PP graduate program that we're about to launch, and so many other initiatives.
In the Western Zone, when I was in the Western Zone, we lost one of our staff, blessed memory. MD came around for the funeral with other gems. I can't take this away. MD participated in everything, including lifting the coffin of our late staff. That was so touching. I said, wow, we have an MD.
Farid is an embodiment of the core values of Republic Bank. Amongst these values, I will single out respect for individual for Farid. His respect for staff, customers, and all is unmatched.
I see quality leadership as pivotal in any progress that the bank makes. And that's why I believe that your demonstration of professionalism and technical skills, plus your affable personality, won the willing and active support of the staff and the management team, a situation which has created an environment and conditions for the success the bank has made.
Farid is simply a great manager, a leader, and great mentor.
In his role as managing director, I was able to grow in my work because of the support and the mentorship that he gave me. I learned a lot from you, Farid, but you are just great at doing the things that you do. A great communicator, a solution person. He brings teams together to resolve issues.
He's a result-oriented person, very passionate about the work that he does. He moved his team to actually work together for an excellent result.
And over 40 years' experience in banking has impacted positively on my life, and I believe on the life of other staff of Republic Bank Ghana.
A lot of people lead by authority, but Farid lead by respect and gentleness. He has this unique way of handling issues, and he always lives just as his name means. Farid simply means unique or exception.
He's calm, friendly, knowledgeable, and I like the way he takes issues about staff to heart. You would always learn something from interacting with Farid, even if it's just a few minutes.
Your swift manner that you handle our issues and also provide solutions on time always brought us a good result.
Farid has been a great leader and a great mentor to a lot of staff in Republic Bank, including myself. Very soft, but stern and determined. Very analytical and ensures that the right thing is always done.
Mr. Farid Anta, the uniqueness that I realized immediately I started to interact with him is the message at the end of his emails.
Every job is a self-portrait of the person who does it. Autograph your work with excellence. MD, you autographed your work with excellence.
Indeed, Farid Anta has autographed his work here at Republic Bank with excellence.
Farid has been in this country for a bit under 5 years, but it feels as though he's been around for decades. That speaks to the kind of person we are talking about today. His contribution to the banking industry has been immense. He is not one to hide away from very difficult discussions. He will always bring out the difficult discussions for the right visibility to be expressed on them, so we can all work towards a solution for the benefit of the industry as a whole.
I think we can all agree that Farid has done a sterling job. He has been meticulous, he has been calm, he has built wonderful relations with staff and the board, with government. He's even learning to speak Cree in as labored a manner as it may be. But he has been a great leader, setting an example for all to follow. And I think he deserves every award that he has received, and there have been many over the last few years.
A renewed sense of purpose, refocus, and belongingness in the bank sprung up when you came on. All thanks to your leadership.
Mr. Farid Anta, your coming to Ghana has been nothing short of phenomenal. You have won many laurels for yourself.
So the awards came for you in your capacity as CEO and to the bank as an institution. And it is a clear mark of recognition of how far the bank has come.
And our awards are very interesting. The best private bank, the fastest growing bank, and the most innovative bank, which shows that very, very organically substantive things have been covered during this period.
I will single out Brassey and Kufuridua projects that the bank has undertaken. For Brassey, we changed lives in Brassey, where he was also made the development chief, Nana Kufi. On his installment day was a grand occasion, and I have great fond memories of what MD has done for this bank.
Nana Kufi Osiadie, you're the first in Kwaswahine of Brassey. Money Wejumapa.
You've done a wonderful job. I congratulate you. I believe that you will take satisfaction in knowing that you came to this bank and you're leaving it in a better place than it was when you found it.
We'll forever remember his sweet smiles and the soft touch that he has for humanity. He has made us soar very higher. He has instilled in most of us some discipline. He has encouraged us to move the extra mile and ensure that we have actually achieved our aim.
The site of Republic Court will always remind us and refresh our memories about the time you spent with us in Ghana. As you prepare to leave the country, let me take this opportunity to wish you, your lovely wife and kids, God's blessings in all your future endeavors.
I urge you to continue with your philanthropic work, which I know you and Madam love so much. Keep impacting lives and continue to remain forever blessed.
I want to say that it will be very nice to read a book authored by you. And to Mrs. Anta, we thank you so much for allowing us share him. I am sure by now you are very excited that you're going to have him all to yourself.
He has fought a good fight. He has finished the race. He has kept the faith. He has been here for close to 4 decades. This is the time for him to take the much-needed rest.
I wish you all the best, and I hope you have a good rest because we have really kept you very busy. But I do hope that Republic Finance will have a way of making additional use of the experience for all this period you've worked for Republic Bank, and especially what you've picked up in Ghana.
May all the efforts that you have put and sacrificed for this great institution be rewarded by the Almighty God.
Aiko, Ms. Anta, well done on a successful career at Republic Bank and Republic Bank Ghana Group.
Nana Kufi Osiadie, you're the first. You have imparted and impacted.
And as the psalmist said at Psalm 34 verse 10, all those trusting in God will lack nothing. This is what I pray for you, that anyone who comes into encounter with you will be a blessing. Thank you for being who you are, and thank you for allowing me to be part of your success story. I wish you all the best, boss.
Mr. Farid Anta, Nana Kufi Osiadie, you're the first. On behalf of the President of Ghana, the Board of Directors, Management and staff of Republic Bank Ghana, we say Ayiko. We will miss you.
Farid, happy retirement.